We are moving to the next session again, the fungal infection. Here we are seeing dermatophytes. Dermatophytes, otherwise known as the ringworm infection. We can see some of the factors regarding the dermatophytes. Superficial skin infections caused by dermatophytes are called tinea or the ringworm and are most common form of fungal disease. We can see the etiology. In the etiology, there are three genera of dermatophytes infect skin and appendages. So here, usually three generation of dermatophytes affect the human body. The first one, trichophyton. Second one, microsporum. Third one, epidermophyton. And these dermatophytes are keratinophilic fungi living on dead keratin, so in stratum corneum. Here, the dermatophytes, they are living in the stratum corneum. So the epidermal layer only it affected, especially the dead skin, and they invade that area. Okay. And these dermatophytes induce inflammation in skin due to permeation of their metabolic products into deeper layers and induction of delayed hypersensitivity. So usually in two forms they will produce inflammations. First one, they will release the metabolic products, their metabolic products into our skin deeper layers. So that leads to itching and infections and inflammatory reactions. And the same way they are induction, they are index induct the delayed hypersensitivity. Okay. So these all are the two methods that will cause inflammation. Now we can see the classification of tinea infections based on the region involved or based on the body regions involved. The tinea infection is categorized into tinea corporis, tinea pedis, tinea cruris, tinea unguem, tinea capitis, tinea flavosa, tinea manum, and tinea barbae. Okay, we can see one by one. First one, tinea corporis. Tinea corporis, otherwise known as tinea glabrosa. Tinea glabrosa means, the hairless skin. Okay, so the tinea infected in hairless skin. Okay. The fungal infections involve the glabrous skin and manifest with varying morphological expressions. Most of the morphology will be annular. Annular means ring-shaped. Okay, with relative clearing of the center and an active in periphery. So when you are observing the tinea corporis lesion, the center portion will not have that much itching or that much problem. Okay, it will be clear. Most of the annular lesion in the tinea corporis, the center portions will be clear, but the periphery portions, that is the ring-shaped region, it will be more active. Okay, that will helps to spread from one area to another. This is another picture of tinea corporis. In Malayalam, the same thing. Okay, I felt so. Next one, tinea pedis. It's otherwise known as athlete's foot. The predisposing factors for tinea pedis is
occlusive footwear, hot moist weather, hyperhidrosis, and sharing of marsh places and presence of tinea ungum. So in that first one, occlusive footwear. So occlusive footwear means if there is a limited space and there is no air circulation in the foot, that may cause damage to the foot and may cause the fungal infection. Next one, hot moist weather. Okay, most of the time when you have a hot weather, there will be excessive sweating. Okay, so this excessive sweating that leads to presence of moisture in that area, and it will harbor the microorganism and cause infection. Then hyperhidrosis of soils. Hyperhidrosis means excessive sweating. Without any etiology, the persons may have genetic factor. Okay, so the person will have the excessive sweating, especially the hands and the soles. Okay, we can easily identify this pupil. Okay, for example, when you are writing the exam for 3 hours, due to the sweating, the papers will be wet. Okay, that is the indication of hyperhidrosis. And some patient or some persons, it may have in the our arms or in the hands, and some may have in the soles. Okay, so they will not be able to put shoes. Okay, if they are using shoes, it will cause excessive sweating and bad smell, and there is more chance for the fungal infections. Next one, sharing of wash places. So if the one person is infected with any of the fungal infection, it will transfer to another person due to the sharing. Okay, it may be due to formites, or it may be due to contaminated surface. Okay, whatever it is, sharing that cause contamination or the transfer of infection from one person to another. Then presence of tinea ungum. That means ungum means it's a onychomycosis. Onychomycosis, it's a fungal infection of the nails. Okay, so that may spread to the sole or foot. So that is the predisposing factor of tinea pedis. And in this picture, you can see the tinea pedis. Tinea pedis, I already explained. It is in Malayalam, we will say valangadi. Okay, tinea pedis have interdigital variant and vesicular variant. So, the interdigital variant, it means scaling frequently in the lateral interdigital spaces. So, when you are observing the tinea infection in the leg, if it is in between the finger and it is in the laterally, that means interdigital variant. Okay. Next one, vesicular variant. Vesicular variant in which the vesicles have ruptured. So, it will not be in the interdigital area. It is in the foot. And it will, there will be form of small vesicles, and it may ruptures. Okay.
Usually, the vesicular variant, it is characterized by the development of deep-seated vesicles. Deep-seated vesicles. Vesicles means fluid-containing lesions that usually fuse to form bullae or multilocular blisters. And these vesicles or bullae that contains yellowish gelatinous fluid. And when it is ruptured, the fluid will be escaped, but there will be a painful experience for the patient, and there will be red erosions. Okay, and when it is ruptures, the superficial skin will be peel off, and there will be a red erosion, and it will be more painful to the patient. And pruritus, itchy, that also common in this patient. Okay, usually the location is sole of the feet and also in the heel. Okay.
Okay, this is the best example for tinea pedis. Okay. And the infection is in the interdigital areas. This picture is the example of the vesicular margin of tinea pedis. So you can see the bulle formation, and it will be rupture. This is again another form. After the bulle ruptures, it will be red erythematous lesion, and it will be more painful, and there will be itching and the redness. Okay. Next tinea condition is tinea cruris. Otherwise, it is known as tinea of groin, and it is common in adults than the children. The main predisposing factor is summers and rainy season. I already explained the hot and humid weather, because that time there will be moisture in our body. Okay, the moisture harbors the microorganism. So summer and humid season, or sorry, rainy season, that will leads to the fungal infection. Then occlusion and use of synthetic clothes. Some may allergic to some type of dress. Okay, so these persons don't use that type of clothes, that is better, in order to maintain their skin. Otherwise, due to itching and skin wound, there will be a skin wound. The scratching that may cause the damage to the skin leads to again infections. Then it affects more than men than women, and also it is occur in adults than children.
Usually the site for tinea cruris is groins, genitalia, pubic area, perineal and perianal regions. And when it starts in groin, it may spread to the nearest area. Okay, up to perianal region it will spread. Sometimes it may spread to upper part of the body and may leads to tinea corporis. Okay. The morphology, it's seen on the inner aspect of the thigh as accurate, sharply demarcated plaques with the peripheral scaling. Then there will be papillovesiculation and pustulation. Lesions expand centrifugally. Chronic lesions may show hyperpigmentation, nodule formation and lichenification in center. Centrifugally means the lesions go away from the center. So this is the examples of tinea cruris. So in the groin, there will be a reddish appearance, and we can't say it is in the correct manner, or it is in circular shape. There is no accurate morphology. And it is it may be reddish or brownish plaques appearance, and it will be developing on the upper and inner thigh, usually inner thigh first. Okay, and extending out the extending to the another areas. Okay, it may enlarge to involve the perineum, that I already explained, and up to the perianal regions. And there will be scaling, and there will be chance for vesicle formation. Okay, and we can see the borders because of this reddish appearance up to where it is spread, that we can easily identify. And itching, that is very severe, and due to this itching there will be scratch in the
in the skin. So again, the scratch that increases or predisposed to infection or the inflammation.
And here you can see the brownish appearance of the tinea cruris. I already told there may be chance for reddish appearance or the brownish appearance. Okay. And you will see these conditions in our hospital because most of the bedridden patient or if the patient is sick and if mentally disabled, so that patients may are in the risk of fungal infections. Okay, lot of cases you can see regarding the tinea cruris in our hospitals.
Tinea onchium, that is the next tinea infection. So that means the infection that affects the nails, otherwise known as the onychomycosis. And you can see thick and discolored broken nail plate. Okay, when you are observing the nail, there will be thick nail and it will be easily broken. Okay, and the nail plate may separate from the nail bud and the nail may be separate from the nail bud, so the nail will be easily went off. And it is anthrophilic orthophilic in nature. Here that means it may, the parasite may cause from an animal or any animal host, it may transfer to the human. Okay, so that's why we are saying that away from cat, then cow, etc., or you have to maintain hygiene while dealing with these animals because they may cause infections. Okay, so that is tinea onchium. This is the another picture of onychomycosis, and usually you will see this condition especially the older adult group. You will see this type of conditions especially the onychomycosis. Most of the adult person, especially they are immunocompromised.